Okay, in this video, we will discuss on how to create model, solid model or and surface model in Autodesk Inventor Professional 2022, and then run linear buckling analysis and also non-linear analysis in Nastran. Okay, this is first of all, this is the interface that you can see when we start the Autodesk Inventor. So what you need to do next is create new model. You can directly press this button, standard template, and then you can change here the configuration, I mean the measurement unit and also drawing standard, then just press this part if you want to create part, and then assembly if you want to combine parts. Okay, it's more than one part, you can combine it into one single assembly. So then if you want to study the what you call it the interaction between the parts when you assign when you apply load on one part, and then the part is connected in pin or fixed connection, or there is a what you call it configuration of or contact between these two parts, so then you can you have to use the assembly instead of part. Okay, in our case, we are going to use we are going to create a part here. So press this button and then it start. Just to need to check and to ensure if you want to ensure whether we use a proper unit. So you can go to this tab tools and then check the document setting, and then there is a window will appear on your screen, and then the unit here in millimeter and kilogram, it's already set, and then you can see here the dimension display in 3-digit, and then this is a 2 only 2-digit. I can close. Okay, and then on the top here we can see there is file here. If you want to open the file or save as the model into different what call it different format, so it's allowed, it is allowed to have here. You can export the model into different what call it AutoCAD format or CAD format, and then to open new and or to share view, you can see the model. So then it's a collaborative design here. You can ask your friend or your team member to give comment. Okay, this is the ribbon. You can see here in 3D model we have extrude, revolve and so on and so forth here, and then also the sketch we have a line, circle, and then this is most of it is in gray color because it is not active, no any sketch being activated here. Then we have a node here, inspect, and we have measure. We can measure between two line, between two point, the area and the volume and so on and so forth, and there are tools here, and then we have manage. There are many things here we can explore later on, and then this is the visualization on how you want to see the model in the realistic, shaded or wireframe and so on and so forth. Somehow it's quite useful, and then also what call it reduce the computational time or the the machine cost. So if you anyway using this wireframe instead of the rendering one or realistic one. And then for the simulation we have here stress analysis. Is this one is the native belong to Inventor, but it is limited study can be done here for stress analysis. You cannot use for what you call it advanced our analysis that considering complex contact, surface contact, and also the non-linear setup. And then we have here Autodesk Inventor Astran. So then it will be here after you install the Autodesk Inventor Astran. So you have to install the Autodesk Inventor Professional and then download the Autodesk Inventor Astran, and then Autodesk Inventor Astran will be extension, let's see, like this, under the environment. Okay, so then Astran is part of the NASA previously, Nastran and Pastran. So it's very powerful finite element engine, finite element modeling and finite element analysis engine. Okay, so then the rest you can extract by yourself lah. You can explore by yourself later on. Okay, let me start to construct our model. So to construct, we start with the 2D sketch. Or you also can also anyway, the to construct 3D model required 2D model first. So go to sketch and then after that you press this button 2D sketch. Or before we continue, we have here on the left side here there is a panel here, model explorer here. Then everything that you created will be listed here. And then on the right here we have the orbit, the pen, and then the cube here. So you can change what you call it the view from here. Okay, that we start the sketching. Press this start to the sketch, and then you have to select which plane that you want to use. Let's say this one. So then in this first in this video we will learn how to create a solid model and surface model. They are two different things. They are two different, what you call it, two different purpose lah. When you do the solid model, so then the interaction between element will be in the 3D solid volume. But when you create your model in surface or cell model, so then it is more, what you call it, lighter, and then you can save the what you call it, the computational cost of your machine. Okay, and then to navigate your working area or model here that you created later on, you can scroll in, scroll out, scroll down and scroll up to zoom in and zoom out. Then also you can use this cube here. Later we explore more. And then to panning, you just click the third button of your mouse, the roller. You move it, bring it and hold it, and then move it. And then if you press shift button and then also the what call it, the roller, so then this orbit view, instead of accessing those thing using this one, you can also using this orbit, free orbit, and then this is the zoom windows. Okay, anyway, let me start. We create the solid model first. After that we create the surface model. Okay, so then to create the model, so we start with the line here. Okay, let's say I create a construction line here. Okay, let's say this one 50 millimeter, and then after that later on I will delete this line, and then after that 100 millimeter here, and then for the 30 degree This is 90 degree. So then for 30 degree, so as in what we call it, Annex D of Euroco 3 Part 15 on the corrugated plate girder with corrugated web. So the arrangement of the slanted or bended plate is 30 degree. So then actually you can explore more than 30 degree, because 30 degree is too quite slanted. So then the function of the bending that will use as strengthening is not so not give what kind of the intention to have this corrugated one. But anyway, in the Euroco 3 Part 15 NXD, the one that we have is only 30 degree the angle. So how to create the 30 degree angle? So then you can see here, we have when we create a line here, we have between these two line, a continuation of the from the previous line. So we have degree and then the length. Yeah. So then if we want to have a 30 degree here, so then it's supposed to be 60. Yeah? 60 degrees, because 30 degrees from the vertical one. So 60 degree plus 90 is 150. Yeah? 150. This is the length. So make it 500 letter, we trim it. And then we tap there, you can see there, so it's 145, we make it 150, enter, like that. So then it is 60 degree, 150 degree from the vertical line that we create previously. Okay, so then I create another, construction line or additional line 50 that later on we will delete this one, actually to create line that intersect this one, and then later we trim it, then hit there. So how to trim? So you can go select on the top here, there is trim, and then you can trim directly, trim here, click. Anyway, why we cannot trim here? Because we have constraint 500 here. How to remove this one? First, we escape, release the command, and then select this one. This is the dimension will become the what call it, the constraint, and then we delete like that. So then, we can do trimming. We trim this one, and then we have to trim this one. We delete this one as well, because later we have to create another line, delete there, and then this first part here is the half of the length of the line here. Go here and then straight 200, this is half, this is double of this one. Okay, Allahu Akbar. I press the F1. So then escape. We can utilize this. The one that already created by do mirroring, and then to do mirror, we required mirroring line. So then we select. This one, and then press shift button, and then select additional selection, and then after that we do mirror here, and then select the mirror line, then and apply. So we have there, and then so we delete this one, and after that move, select these two, we move, select the base point, and then yes, it is because there is a what call it constraint. This one the what call it this dimension as a constraint. So then there, okay. So it's not changing the constraint, it's maintaining 200, and then done. Since we already know the dimension, and then to release the constraint, can do deleting this one. And then we don't need these two. Then we can delete. Also, we can delete this one. Okay. Then after that, we copy all this thing. Copy and then select the base point, and then directly go here. It's snapping to the end. Then escape. So then we have the shape of the corrugated shape. And then after that, we do what we call it. This is the center line. We offset. We offset here. Okay. Before that, so we select all this one, and after that, we lock into one, become one set. After that, we select this one. Sorry. We escape. Select this one. Offset. Oops. Sorry. Supposed to be, I would like to select all this thing. Anyway, let me use the other method way. Right click and then sketch doctor, diagnose, okay, next combine sketch point, finish. Will I have to combine? Yes, hopefully it will combine everything. I'm not sure. Offset, yes, it's already set. And then let's say we need to we have a thickness of the web six millimeter, so three here and then three there. So then after that we delete the middle one here. I don't know, maybe there is or there are faster way to create this one. I'm doing the hard way here. I'm not experiencing, I mean not experienced person. Okay, here. Then we create this one to close the, what you call it, this shape. Done. Then finish the sketch. So sketch one here, we have on the left side here. And then if you go right click, so you have this menu. So edit the sketch or redefine or to measure, or use a visible dimension, feasibility, and so on and so forth. Okay. So then, since the sketch already finished, the sketch already there. So then you can access the 3D model here. Before that, I want to delete this one. There is a, what call it, right click and then edit sketch. So this is the point that I do not need. Finish the sketch and then do extrusion. And then extrusion, you can see there, it's upward. And then the spacing is, the length is, I make it 1000 millimeter, so it is done. 1000 millimeter. Can also change the direction or use this one. Or you can also which elevation or which work plane, and then okay. So we have already have here. And after that, we create the top flanks and bottom flanks. How to do it? So we create this 2D sketch on top of it, this we create the plane basically. We start with this plane, then here, and after that we create line. So let's say from this middle, snap to the mid point, and then 200 to left side, and then after that to right side, and then 100 to the 100 here, 100 there, and then after that we can do offset directly there. Let's say 15 millimeter. And then you close. There. Close. There. Okay. And after that, do the same thing here. You create the other one here. Oops, sorry. Sketch number 3. Or sketch number 3. Create line here as well from the middle here to there, 200, and then from there 100, oops, sorry, you can go there, return back 100. Also you can do something like this, create a rectangle here, and then the other side here is the thickness, make sure 15 millimeter, and then check the tag 300, and then enter. So you can do like that as well. So then not necessary to delete as so we can delete the element here. Okay, you have finished the sketch here. Then after that, you create the extrude for this one, downward 1000. Okay, and also goes to this one, extrude to this one, downward. Okay, so then you already have these two. And after that, you create the top flanks and bottom flanks. So same goes here. You have to create. Okay, use this one. The plane, use this plane to start to create the top flanks. We use rectangle to point. We have reference already, so easy. That one, and then done. And after that, do extrude here, and then extrude for 30 mm, and then okay. So it's directly it's weld. And combine, you can see here. It's wet. And after that, for the bottom side here, you go to the sketch, then go select for this one, and then create the rectangle for top here. Snap to this end, and then snap to this end, and then finish this that one, and extrude the shape. Okay, so it's detect the last. So then basically we have already have here. What call it? The 3D solid for one panel of what call it? A corrugated web plate girder. Okay, so then after that, we can continue with simulation. Go to environment tab. And then after that, press Autodesk Inventor. So then we have here on the left side here is the mod. You have several tabs here. This is the model, and then Nastran Model 3, Nastran Output, and Nastran File. So basically, after you create the model, finish, and then you can directly you can generate the Nastran file and then run. Your model, if your model is very complex, so then preferable you run the analysis not in the inventor, but directly inside the Nastran. So when you install the Autodesk Inventor Nastran, they have Nastran separately as well. So it is what call it scripting. So you just create the Nastran file and then run it in the Nastran software. Okay, let me go use this one, linear static. We double click and then we select the type of analysis, linear buckling option. Here we need to have three mode of buckling. At least we can see how it is look like. And after that, this is the material, the idealization. It's already, some of it already pre-generated for you. Check here, the solid, I mean the since we have only one part, so basically this belong to this part. But we have to check, we have to change. Double click the generic and then select the material, take from the Autodesk material library and then select the S for the steel. Find the ASUS N5 or S355. Let me use this one. Okay, if you want to still if you want to change the parameters here, you can still allow. Okay, so linear buckling, it is a linear analysis, so then no need to apply the non-linearity here, non-linearity of materials, and then just press OK here. Okay, so under the mesh model here, it is there is an exclamation mark here. It is because we haven't run the model, meshing the mesh. So then we can run it later. So then loading, we create new loading and then we assign it to this face. Select entities, and then this is one is the magnitude already in Newton. So -100,000 Newton. So easy for us later on to calculate or to multiply the eigen value that we got from the analysis with this applied load. So give us the buckling capacity directly. So select the entity. So this surface, and select this surface. Okay, and then okay. So it's directly downward. And new constraint. On this side, so basically we it is to simplify the long model, the big model. So then we assume that it is a beam that's subjected to predominantly shear. So then it is an what do you call it? We can make it as a cantilever that subject to shear, purely shear, but to ensure it is not rotated, so then we assign constraint about X axis and then about Z axis. About Y axis, we release it to allow it to translate. Select the entities, this face, like that, and then OK. Then after that, this constraint, you create new constraint and then let it is make it fixed. Select entities here, so we create cantilever predominantly subjected to what you call it, shear. Okay, that. Then basically it's all here, only the mesh model. So we generate, right click here, generate mesh, or you can press this button, generate mesh. If you want to make it more denser, so then you can increase and then have the custom here, add mesh control. I say add mesh control along the what call it, edge here or specific area can also. So generate mesh, let it define by itself. So basically there is the analysis or behind. So it will give you appropriate, sufficient size of the mesh. Okay, so you can also change the mesh setting here. It's basically 70. So then you can make it finer. Okay. And okay, so then also you can tick this one. Okay, let it as it is. Then after that you can run the analysis. It will ask you to save the model. So part number 3, maintain the this one and then save. Yes. Then it will run the linear Buckley analysis. It is quite fast. So the warning I left it is like that. It is run the analysis using the, then it's very fast, right? Okay. So then it give you the, this is the third mode. The first mode, this is one, 129. The eigenvalue is 129. So multiply by the 100 kilonewton, so give you 1200 kilonewton as a buckling capacity. It is because of a contribution of the, what do you call it, of this top flanks and bottom flank as well. So from here you can have a stress given here, and then it is exaggerated. So you can change the, what do you call it, the option here. What call it, deform. You can go to option and then change the deformation. Let's say make it actual, can also so it is actual one, or you can increase by how many percent, let's say 5%, and okay. Then after that you press the deform, so it give you the deformation only, and then you can see here the 30 degree is not give what call it stiffening the web. It's not so provide stiffener to the plate. So then you can try for 45 degree or more steeper. Okay, then for the what call it nonlinear analysis, you can create here a new you can create, right click, new analysis, directly use the same model and then different analysis. Nonlinear transient, nonlinear analysis, linear static analysis, option, no option here. Large displacement, yes, on. Mode save, not need to, then only, and then okay. So the first analysis, Buckley analysis, will be in gray color, and then it's not inactive. Currently it's nonlinear static analysis here, active. So we have a CAD model already there here, and then mesh model we haven't create generated. So then the things that we don't have here is the idealization. So then we start with the idealization solid model number 2. So we already have here. So if you want to make new material or using the same material here, it's okay here, solid number 2, then okay, and then only you need to change idealization non-linear here. Non-linear analytic, we can use the bilinear, or you can use the plastic condition. So you can assign based on the test, material test. Elastic plastic, bilinear, it is also suggested suggested by the Eurocode 3 Annex C. So this one can see here, you can see, and then you can refer to that one. We use 10% 10% of the what do you call it, modulus, elastic. So we use instead of this is 10% of the modulus elastic, and then okay, and then okay, and then we assign. Because since anyway this one is only one part, so then assign to everything. So how You can assign separately later on. If let's say material, the web different, or the flanks different. And then after that, non-linear setup here. Intermediate output we set on number of increment, let's say 10. So it mean the load that you assign must be bigger than the buckling capacity that you got from the linear buckling analysis. So currently we have 12.9, right? The eigenvalue. So then we multiply with the 100 kilonewton, give us something like that. Then after that, later we apply load then. So then a number of increment 10 start from 0.1, 0.2, something like that. 10% increment. So then easier lah to divide. So then after that, advanced setting here, you have to set here to auto. And then based on the loading different, because it is what call it convergent, so we set increment of 0.1. If it is achieved, so then it is converged. So then you can set also by based on displacement as well. So I suggest you take only the load increment 0.1. So basically for the engineering analysis, generally we can use the 0.1 only. If you want to make it more sensitive, so then you can make it 0.01. The smaller the value that you place here, so then when it is not achieve the different of the converse criteria, so then it will not stop the analysis. I mean, it will continue to repetitively run the analysis. And after that, a maximum bisection. Bisection is mean when it is load achieved but not converse, then it divide by 2, divide by 2, something like that. So make it 40. Okay, and then press OK. So basically this is the basic, what's called it, non-linearity analysis. And then loading, the new load here, same. We place we have 1290, right? Point. Newton. It is the one that increase, or maybe we can increase it to 13. So it is what do you call it? 13,000 kilonewton. More than the analysis one. Let me check. Let me see whether it is can be, because we got the eigenvalue, the value is anyway, when we use the mass previously, so we start with the quiet cores. So then the smaller, the denser the mass, so basically it will more accurate, more. So give you so then you have to deal with the density of the mass as well. Depends on the performance of your computer. And then okay here. And then the constraint new. Let me release all those thing, only Z and X. Put it here. Okay. And then another one for fix. You put it the other side here. Okay. And then basically, then we generate the mesh. Let me just use the default one. And you can change because this one the color is too light. So maybe you can double click this color, and then you select the darker one. So that one, okay. Then after that, this one. So you can see here in the under the cube here we have what we call it orthographic and perspective. So perspective will give you more perspective view lah. I mean, what do you call it? View more point of views look like a real one. This one orthographic, orthogonic, orthographic. And then nonlinear analysis, the element already done here. Then you can run. Let me check. The run the analysis. So it's quiet. So you can see the first increment already completed. Increment number 2 also completed. Increment number 3, 4. So it's basically it's already buckling. The yield already reached. Maybe because of the load that we assigned to big. So you can see there normally when there is an increment or there is a non-linearity achieved, so the iteration maybe will be there is a sub increment or sub division on that one. So there is a non-linearity normally occurred. Maybe the load that we apply to big here. So we already achieve 190 millimeter of deformation, quite big. Yeah, this happened because of what you call it, maybe the the load that we assign to big here beyond the yield. So bisection is already increment, maximum increment already achieved 50. We stop the analysis. Go to Nastran. We have this one. Let me stop. Okay. It's incomplete. So we have up to So then, this because I have the run at the back, screen captured. So then it is not appear. This one, maybe sharing the graphic card. So let me change the load instead of it's too big. Make it 13, 1,300 kilonewton. Then run the analysis. See, the yield already not achieved. The yield is 2075. So then, increment number 8 already yield 340. Deformation option here maybe because we set previously Actual, make it 10%. Okay. So you can see 0.1 and then 10. This supposed to be buckle somewhere else, somewhere. It's not seen here. Not so clear here. So then we can do maximum displacement. Let me see. So there is a non-linearity achieved. I mean, it's already non-linear. 0.7. So it's basically the capacity of buckling capacity of this one achieved when the load factor 0.7. So 0.7 times 1,300 is supposed to be about what do you call it? How much is it? 600 kilonewton. Okay. So then also you can create your own plot here. Let's say for the element, let's say you select the element here. Name element, select the element here. And then solid normal stress. So if you want to study what is the stress on that one, von Mises stress, and after that we add solid normal stress for this one, solid von Mises. And then you show the plot. Oops, sorry, this is not correct. And this is it? Let me check. Let me. It's the idea. The ID here. Solid von Mises. Solid von Mises. And we add. And so plot. Oh, this. You can see here. This is a linear. Still linear. And at this area, still linear. Maybe at that certain area, this. But it's already yield. But it is linear. Not. We cannot see the what you call it the non-linearity. This also happen it because of the material that we use. Currently on we set this one 10%. If it is only 5%, so then it will be different. So there is a guideline for the modeling in the NXC of Yuroko 3 part 1.5 on this one. So let me run one more time so you can see the deformation on this one. So then you can compare the linear buckle analysis and this one. So the one that I ask you to do for your mini project, you do parametrical analysis, change the what you call it, the parameter of the corrugated parameters. So it's not so same. Okay. Let me see here. This one, that it is not, because it is too. It's not so. So this look like it is distributed. Because we have less numbers of what do you call it meshing. So if we increase, you can see the deformation and also the stress development. Okay, anyway, that's all for solid. For the surface, I will prepare another video. Thank you very much.